Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to generate a .pem file for your Intel SDK app. .pem file is required to send push notifications from your own server to Apple servers. And if you are building a legacy app, in that case you don't need a .pem file because PushMobi automatically generates a .pem file on server side and the procedure is different for them. But in this video I'm going to show you the creation of a .pm file for your hybrid app, and you have to do that because hybrid apps use the third-party plugins for enabling push notification service on their app. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my keychain access, and over here I'm going to go to create assistant, certificate assistant, and then click on request a certificate from a certificate authority, and here type your email address and then save this to disk. Okay, so now make sure you have this new two keys created just now, and then what you have to do is you have to go to your developer.apple.com and then to your certificates, identifiers and profiles dashboard. Over here you have to create a new certificate for your push notification. Make sure you click this Apple push notification service via SSL, and then select your app for which app you need this certificate, and then upload your certificate, the one you just created using keychain. Download it. And you can see the certification is downloaded now. So now what you need to do is I'm just going to rename it. I'm just going to remove this space characters and the two over here so that it will look much clearer. And then I'm going to double click on it, and you will see this certificate listed over here. And now you have to generate the .p12 files. You have to create two .p12 files. First, you have to click export on this certificate, and then save this one as cert.p12. Provide a password, and remember this is a very important password. You have to use this to send a push notification to Apple servers, and this is your Mac password, the operating system password. So the file is saved, and then you have to generate a key and .p12 file, name it p, and then save it. Enter the same password for this also, and this is your Mac password. So you have .p12 files, there are two files. Now you don't need keychain anymore. Now you have to use the OpenSSL tool to actually combine these two into one file called as .pem. For that, I have some of the commands pre-written for me. So first command is to generate .pm file for our cert.p12 file. So what I'm going to do before doing anything is I'm going to go to my desktop first. I'm going to change the directory. And then now I'm going to generate it. Make sure you enter the same password, and you can see that the first .pm file is generated. And now I'm going to copy this second command. And you can see the second .pm key.pm file is also generated. Now I'm going to combine these two into one .pm file. And you can see this is combined into ck.pm. This is the important file, and now you don't need any of these files. You can just delete them of your wish, so you don't need anymore. And this is the file you need now to actually send notifications to Apple servers. So this is the most important file now. So thanks for watching this video. Continue watching this tutorial for learning how to put up push notifications in iOS.